And down the ice it goes again with 55 seconds remaining in Van Impe's penalty. Gusev's long pass. Clark watching Harlamov. Harlamov circles inside his own line. He got by Bobby Clark to center. Clark still after him. Up over the line and he's bumped off the puck, and the Flyers send the Soviets back for it. Gusev winding up again. Dropped it over to Harlamov. In his own zone, out to center, Mikhailov backs up again, and they get going on the power play now. Everybody's circling. Gusev was belted hard by Dupont. Oh, what a check at the blue line. Down the ice for Vasilyev in his own zone. Barber ran into him and knocked him flying. Harlamov in the corner. He had it poked away from him. The Flyers getting physical now. Oh, Harlamov was really belted by Bill Barber right in. Oh, the backhand shot. And Harlamov is still dizzy after that check. Out it comes to the line. And this is Mikhailov going down. The penalty is over. Flyers at close range. Mikhailov, oh, again. Harlamov is really belted by Van Impe. And he's prostrate on the ice. Van Impe from the penalty box ran into Harlamov. The Soviets are all standing up. They want a penalty, but I'll tell you, Dick, that was a solid check, and I didn't see too much wrong with it.
Certainly in the games I've seen, I would have to think this is the toughest exchange. Denny, I don't know how rough it was last night at the island, but in these last few moments, we have seen more physical contact than in any of the games that I've seen, either in person or on the television version of it. Here it comes again now. This is part of it. I'm not sure what's the one. There's the one we have just seen with Van Impe against Harlamov. And he, as Bob mentioned, is shaky. He's up now, and he's back to the bench.
It just seems as though it was a pretty good, solid check, and the checks have been pretty solid and I think pretty honest so far in the game. It seems as though Philadelphia has got the Soviets leery of them, and they're watching for it to get hit.
Now we have got the Soviets asking for the referee to come over. There is Victor, as he's known, the interpreter, who is there. Lokhtev, the coach, is very upset.
Dick, down on the other end of the bench, Mikhailov and Alexandrov have their sticks up to their right. Now, who's to their right? The Flyers are farther down. They can't reach them. But Alexandrov and Mikhailov have their sticks high, and we couldn't quite see what had happened after the crowd got up.
Well, that's the scene right there. We can't see it from where we are because we are within the crowd. Everyone is standing up in front of us. Now, I think Gilmore is giving a penalty to the Soviet bench. 2 minutes. We'll have to wait for the announcement on this, but that would appear to have been the call made by referee Gilmore, who is the man in the middle. And it's a delay of game penalty against the Soviets. And now I notice some of the Soviet players turning around applauding back at the crowd with grins on their faces. There is the interpreter. He's the tall chap you see standing there. And the signs are hauled up. And obviously they came prepared. That's the sign man down to our left behind the Soviet net.
Dick, Matt Pavlich, number 7, the linesman, also understands Russian, and he is helping out with, as you point out, the tall gentleman, Victor. And that's Lokhtev to his right, who's rather perturbed at this stage. But Pavlich understands the language, and he's trying to help out there.
They are leaving the ice.
They're going to go.
The Soviets are leaving.
They're going home. They're going home. Yeah. They're going home.
Can you imagine? Denny, it's been a short afternoon.
Oh, it's terrible. They're acting like a very frustrated hockey club, and I think they're displaying poor sportsmanship.
Can you believe it, Dennis?
I certainly can't believe it. I thought they'd have a little more pride in to play the game.
In 72 in Moscow, we stayed, and we took it all. And in 74, and now the Philadelphia Flyers room around a little bit, and they're going home.
Well, Aggie Kuklowitz, who is always a very important man in situations like this in these international-type hockey competitions, has left his spot in the penalty box and has gone directly to the Soviet room. I got a feeling there's going to be a lot of persuasion tried right about here. Whether they are going to just call it quits or have to be talked into coming back, I don't know. they were certainly, Denny, being outplayed as far as the game was concerned. Freddie Shiro, who said prior to the game, this is the biggest day of his life, must be equally as frustrated as everybody in the building is.
It seems to me in 72 that the Canadians going over to Russia were subject to all of the abuse and all of the circumstances, that we were at a disadvantage. And I certainly can't understand why the Russians would not accept the situations here in Canada or in the United States not being all that bad. Simple fact that it seems as though they're being outplayed and they're playing like a frustrated hockey club.
Dennis, right now, I can't imagine why they're going home unless, of course, it was that last call by the referee of a 2-minute penalty for delay of game.
I think the Russians have seen themselves hurt a few Canadian players, and I'm sure that incidents like that have happened before. As far as we could see, it seemed like a solid body check, and I could not see anything wrong with it or dishonest. And I really can't understand their reaction to the calls.
The teams played 11 minutes and 21 seconds in this first period. No score. Now, here is the play that has brought about this controversial situation. Coming in to the left of your screen, you'll see Ed Van Impe, and he knocks Harlamov down to the ice. Now, the Soviet player lay there for a few seconds and then got up and made his way back to the bench. Meanwhile, the Soviet coach called all of his players over to the bench, and when he would not resume the game, they, of course, thought a penalty should have been called. When he would not resume the game, Gilmore then assessed a 2-minute delay of game penalty. Scotty Morrison, the NHL referee in chief, plus Frank Udvary, who has been the NHL chaperone for the Army team there as well. So a strange situation. We'll be back. Game 8 of Super Series 76 is coming to you from the Spectrum in Philadelphia. The Soviet Army team is back on the ice here at the Spectrum with 8:39 left to play in the first period and a scoreless hockey game. The delay has been approximately 15 minutes. Ron Andrews of the National Hockey League was downstairs while the discussion was being held. The gist of the story is this. The Soviets have said they do not want to be part of a boxing match. They said that they would continue the hockey game, but that boxing is not a part of hockey. And they don't like what they see their players being hit on the jaw. At the same time, they protested violently the 2-minute delay of game penalty, which was assessed and which will stand, I assume, when it's all over. Clarence Campbell, Alan Eagleson, and the various officials, the refereeing staff, and the Soviet team officials were in on the discussion. Also, they checked with the Flyers. Keith Allen had stated that he did not want his team to be intimidated and have to change its style of play because of the Soviets' reaction. Now, that was Ron's story as he came up, and about 2 minutes after he did come up, the teams began returning to the ice. So that's where it stands. On the clock right now, there is no indication that the penalty is being assessed, but the penalty door is open, and Gilmore surely has to make that penalty stand, I am sure. So a very, very dicey moment on the international hockey scene. Bob Cole, you saw a few dicey ones in 72 to get in 74, and here we are once more.
You know, Dick, it's an incredible story. I guess somebody should write a book along those lines. All the confusion that prevailed in the 72 series. And you have to give full marks to a person like Alan Eagleson, who came through it all with flying colors, and never let his feathers get out of the way at all. Had a lot of patience and ironed everything out when problems did occur. And then in 74, much the same. We had all types of problems with officials and selections of officials and so on. But they always seem to, the favor always goes to the Soviet Union. We sort of back up and give them a go. But let's see what happens now. As play is underway again, there's no score. The Soviet team is shorthanded on that bench minor. And this is Leach shooting it in. Back of the goal. Lukotko, he was bumped lightly. Barber took a shot. They score! Reggie Leach.
Well, Denny, you mentioned about the reaction that something like that might have on the team, the Soviet team, and bingo, we come out, and in about 40 seconds worth of hockey time, the Flyers have scored. Pretty good deflection by Leach.
Certainly is. Reggie Leach is has that habit of coming in from behind the net and standing in front when that shot is taken. And it was there for that perfect deflection as beat Trechak. Trechak never had a chance at it.